Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to see about the anatomy of heart. So, anatomy of heart mainly focusing on chambers and grooves. Chambers of the heart and grooves on the heart. Heart is a hollow conical muscular organ situated in the middle mediastinum and is covered by the pericardium. It has outer fibrous pericardium, which is single layered, and inner serous pericardium, which is double layered, with outer parietal layer and inner visceral layer. Now, this heart we'll study under different headings like synonym, situation, size and weight, then chambers and grooves. So, first about the synonym. Heart is also called as core or cardia, and accordingly you get the blood vessels supplying the heart are called as the coronary arteries, and diseases of the heart are called as the cardiac diseases. If you see the situation, it is situated in middle mediastinum. You know, mediastinum is the median space situated between the two pleural cavities, which extends from the sternum anteriorly to the thoracic vertebrae posteriorly, from the inlet of the thorax from above to the diaphragm below. So suppose if you draw here the sternum, here is sagittal section of the mediastinum, where you can see this is the sternum. You know the parts of the sternum. This is manubrium sterni. Here you get the body of the sternum, and this will be the xiphoid process. Here is the outline of thoracic vertebrae. If you draw the inlet of thorax, it will be like this. So it meets the first thoracic vertebra, and here if you draw the diaphragm, diaphragm will be like this. So this is the diaphragm, and if you draw the imaginary line passing through the sternal angle, so here is the sternal angle. This plane meets posteriorly at the lower border of T4 vertebra. Because of that, this mediastinum gets divided in the two parts. Part above the plane is called as the superior mediastinum, and part below the plane is called as the inferior mediastinum. This inferior mediastinum, because of the presence of the pericardium, if you draw here the pericardium, it will be like this. So because of the pericardium, it is divided in the three parts. Part anterior to the pericardium is the anterior mediastinum. Behind the pericardium is the posterior mediastinum. And here, including the pericardium and its content, you get the middle mediastinum. As heart is situated within this pericardium, you get situation of the heart. It is present in the middle mediastinum. Now coming to the size and weight of the heart. Size of the heart is almost equal to the clenched fist of an individual. In female, it weighs about 250 grams, while in case of male, it weighs about 300 grams. From apex to base, it measures about 12 centimeters. Anteroposterior diameter is almost 6 centimeters, and maximum transverse diameter is equal to 8 to 9 centimeters, and this transverse diameter is almost half of the transverse diameter of the thoracic cavity. On x-ray, if the transverse diameter of the heart is more than the half of the transverse diameter of thoracic cavity, the condition is called as the cardiomegaly. So that is about the size and weight. Now coming to the chambers of the heart. For the chambers of the heart, we'll draw the diagram of the heart from the anterior view and the posterior view. Suppose this is the right border of the heart. Here you get the inferior border of the heart. Here is the left border of the heart, apex of the heart. Okay, then here you'll get the right auricle, superior vena cava, which is formed by union of the right and the left brachiocephalic veins. So here will be the superior vena cava. Here you will get the aorta, arch of aorta with the three branches. From right to the left, they are the brachiocephalic trunk, left common carotid artery and left subclavian artery. This is the arch of aorta. And just below that, here we will draw the pulmonary trunk with the two pulmonary arteries. So here, this is the pulmonary trunk. This is ascending aorta. And here, you will get left auricle, anterior interventricular groove. And here will be the inferior vena cava. So this is actually the anterior view. This is the anterior view of the heart. If you see the posterior view of the heart, it will be like this. Suppose here is the left border of the heart, your inferior border almost horizontal. Here will be the left auricle. You will get the four pulmonary veins which open in this left atrium. Then here will be the posterior atrioventricular groove, posterior interventricular groove. Here somewhere you can see the two pulmonary arteries. Here you will get the arch of aorta. And here will be the superior vena cava, which opens in the right atrium. Here you will get the inferior vena cava. This is inferior vena cava. So this is the posterior view. This is the posterior view of the heart. Now coming to the chambers of the heart, we know heart consists of four chambers, two atria and two ventricles, right and left atria, right and left ventricles. Atria are the receiving chambers. Right atrium, so this is actually right atrium, right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from whole of the body through superior vena cava, inferior vena cava and coronary sinus, while left atrium receives the oxygenated blood through the four pulmonary veins, two superior, two inferior pulmonary veins from on the right side and left side. And this right atrium then pumps the blood into the right ventricle. From the right ventricle, blood passes to the pulmonary trunk, and through the pulmonary trunk it goes to the lungs for the oxygenation. Here the oxygenated blood again returns back to the left atrium through the four pulmonary veins. This oxygenated blood is pumped to the left ventricle, and from the left ventricle it is pumped into the ascending aorta. That means the right chambers of the heart contain deoxygenated blood and the left chambers of the heart contain oxygenated blood. Now coming to the chambers exactly. So here this chamber is the right atrium. This is the right atrium, which you can see from the posterior view also. Part of it is seen from the posterior view, and this is right atrium. This right atrium is a elongated chamber of the heart. It receives superior vena cava at the upper end and inferior vena cava at the lower end. From its anterosuperior part, you get this ear-like appendage which passes towards the left side and overlaps the root of the ascending aorta, and this is the infundibulum of the right ventricle. And this ear-like appendage is called as the right auricle. This right auricle is notched. It has notch margins. So that is about right atrium and right auricle. Now left atrium is seen only from the posterior view. So this is the left atrium. This left atrium receives the oxygenated blood through four pulmonary veins. So these superior, inferior, right pulmonary veins and left pulmonary veins. So this is the left atrium. This left atrium has the ear-like appendage, so here, which extends anteriorly and it encroaches the root of the pulmonary trunk, and this is called as the left auricle. It is also notched on the outer surface. That is about the two atria. Now coming to the ventricles, from the anterior view you can see here this area. So this is the right ventricle. This is the right ventricle. Part of the right ventricle is seen on the inferior surface. So this is right ventricle. You get the part which is left over here. So this is the left ventricle. This is the left ventricle. So here you can see the left ventricle on the inferior surface. Major part of the inferior surface will be formed by this left ventricle. So these are the four chambers of the heart, two atria and two ventricles. Now coming to the grooves of the heart. So mainly there are three grooves. So first is atrioventricular groove. Atrioventricular groove, it is also called as coronary sulcus. Coronary sulcus. The other groove you get is interventricular groove. This interventricular groove has two parts, anterior part and posterior part, and interatrial groove. So these grooves actually separate the four chambers of the heart from each other, and they also contain the blood vessels of the heart. So first we will see about the atrioventricular groove or coronary groove. This atrioventricular groove, as the name suggests, it exists between the atria and the ventricles. And this atrioventricular groove is C-shaped. It is C-shaped. If I draw here the atrioventricular groove, it will be over here. It is C-shaped groove. It is present on the posterior view like this. It is deficient anteriorly because of the pulmonary trunk, and that's why it is not completely circular. It is C-shaped. It is deficient anteriorly because of the pulmonary trunk. Now this atrioventricular groove separates atria and ventricles. It is divided into the two parts. The one which is seen from anterior view is called as the anterior part, and the part which is seen from the posterior view, this is the posterior part of atrioventricular groove. Anterior part of atrioventricular groove, again because of the presence of pulmonary trunk, is divided into the right anterior and the left anterior atrioventricular groove. So now we will see what are the contents of this groove. So this right anterior atrioventricular groove, it runs downwards and towards the right side. It lies between the right atrium and the right ventricle, and it lodges the right coronary artery and one vein, and the vein here is the small cardiac vein. It lodges small cardiac vein. Coming to the left anterior atrioventricular groove, it lodges two arteries and two veins. So the arteries in this groove, you get here the left coronary artery. Suppose here you get the left coronary artery. This divides into the anterior interventricular and the circumflex branch. So this artery is a left coronary artery, and this is the circumflex branch of the left coronary artery. This artery, it runs here, is the anterior interventricular artery. This is anterior interventricular artery. Here you get one vein, and this vein is great cardiac vein. This vein is great cardiac vein. Great cardiac vein. This great cardiac vein enters into the left anterior atrioventricular groove to terminate into here one large venous channel called coronary sinus. Coronary sinus. That means here, if you see carefully, this left anterior atrioventricular groove, it runs towards the left side. It lies between the left auricle and the left ventricle, lodges two arteries and two veins. Two arteries are trunk of the left coronary artery and circumflex branch of left coronary artery. Two veins, the termination of the great cardiac vein and the commencement of the coronary sinus. So that is about the left anterior atrioventricular groove. If you see the posterior part of the atrioventricular groove, it lodges the anastomosis between the left coronary artery and the right coronary artery. So here this is the right coronary artery, and here this is left coronary artery. In addition to that, you get this vein. The large venous channel present here is called as the coronary sinus, which drains almost 60% of the venous blood from the heart. So coronary sinus and the anastomosis between the left coronary and the right coronary artery is the content of the posterior atrioventricular groove. Now coming to the other grooves, so anterior interventricular groove. This anterior interventricular groove, it runs downwards. It is situated on the sternocostal or anterior surface of the heart. It runs almost parallel to the left border of the heart, and it lodges anterior interventricular artery and the great cardiac vein. This anterior interventricular artery then winds around the inferior border of the heart to enter here in the posterior interventricular groove. So here this artery is the anterior interventricular artery. Thus you get the two contents of this anterior interventricular groove, that is anterior interventricular artery branch of left coronary artery and the great cardiac vein. Now coming to the posterior interventricular groove. This posterior interventricular groove lodges the posterior interventricular artery, usually the branch of right coronary artery, and the vein here is middle cardiac vein. You get here the middle cardiac vein. In addition to that, as you know, there is anastomosis between the anterior interventricular and the posterior interventricular artery, and the site of the anastomosis usually lies at the junction between anterior 1/3 and the posterior 2/3 of this posterior interventricular groove. This groove lodges or is present on the inferior or diaphragmatic surface of the heart. Now coming to the next groove, that is interatrial groove. This interatrial groove, as the name suggests, lies between the two atria and is not visible from the anterior view because of the pulmonary trunk and ascending aorta. But from posterior aspect, you can see the groove over here, and this groove passes downwards. It is very faint and it passes downwards and meets the posterior atrioventricular groove and the posterior interventricular groove. This meeting point of the three grooves here is called as the crux of the heart. So crux of the heart is the meeting point of three grooves. This is interatrial groove. This is interatrial groove. Here this is posterior interventricular groove, and this is the posterior atrioventricular groove. Because of the crux of the heart, this posterior atrioventricular groove is divided into the left posterior and the right posterior. The part which is present on the left side of the crux is the left posterior atrioventricular groove, and to the right side of it is the right posterior atrioventricular groove. This posterior atrioventricular groove is situated between this area of the heart is called base of the heart, and this area is called as the diaphragmatic surface of the heart. So posterior atrioventricular groove lies between base of the heart and diaphragmatic surface of the heart. So that is about the chambers and the grooves of the heart. Thus you get the three grooves: atrioventricular groove separating the atria from the ventricles, then interatrial groove, which is again having two parts, anterior interventricular seen from the anterior aspect. On the diaphragmatic surface you get the posterior interventricular groove, and on the posterior aspect very faint part of the interatrial groove, and the crux, the meeting point of the interatrial groove, this posterior interventricular groove and the posterior atrioventricular groove. Now the same features of the chambers and the grooves we will see on the specimen of the heart. This is the heart. Heart is hollow conical muscular organ situated in the middle mediastinum. It is covered by the pericardium, outer fibrous pericardium which is single lead, and inner serous pericardium which is double lead. Now we will see chambers of the heart and the grooves on the heart. There are four chambers for the heart, two atria and two ventricles. Right atrium and right ventricle, they contain deoxygenated blood, and left atrium, left ventricle contain the oxygenated blood. 2/3 of the heart lies on the left of the midline and only 1/3 lies on the right side of the midline. Now coming to the chambers of the heart. This is now the anterior view of the heart. This is anterior view of the heart. You can see this chamber. This chamber is the right atrium, which receives the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. So this is right atrium. This right atrium shows the ear-like appendage from its anterosuperior part. From its anterosuperior part, ear-like appendage passes towards the left side. It covers the root of this ascending aorta and infundibulum of the right ventricle, and this is called as the right auricle, which has the notch margins, notch borders. So that is about right atrium and right auricle. You get the left atrium. To see the left atrium, you have to turn the specimen of the heart, and only on the posterior aspect you can see this left atrium. So this is quadrilateral in the outline. This is the left atrium, which receives the superior pulmonary vein, inferior pulmonary vein from the left side. Likewise, right side also you get superior and inferior pulmonary veins. So four pulmonary veins open in this left atrium, which is seen from the posterior view of the heart. Like right atrium, even the left atrium shows ear-like appendage. So here you can see the ear-like appendage, which extends forwards and overlaps the root of the pulmonary trunk. This is called left auricle, which shows the notch margins or notch borders. So this is left auricle, and the part of the left auricle can be seen even from the anterior view of the heart. So that is about atria. Now coming to the ventricles. Atria and ventricles are separated from each other by the groove called atrioventricular groove. Now in my fingers, index finger and thumb, I am holding that atrioventricular groove. So ventricles lie more on the anterior and inferior side than the two atria, and these ventricles themselves are separated from each other by anterior and posterior interventricular grooves. So here you get, this is anterior interventricular groove. To the right side of that you get right ventricle, to the left side of that here you get the left ventricle. If you see from the inferior aspect, again here you can see a groove. This is posterior interventricular groove. To the right side of that, this side, here you get the right ventricle, and to the left side of that you can see the left ventricle. So here you, on the posterior aspect, you can see the posterior interventricular groove separating the two chambers. So here this is the left ventricle, comes over here. So from here to here is the left ventricle, and right ventricle is seen main part on the anterior surface. Small part of it extends on the inferior surface. Okay, so that is about the chambers of the heart. Two atria, two ventricles. And atria show ear-like appendages called right auricle and left auricle. Now, coming to the grooves of the heart, atria and ventricles are separated from each other by atrioventricular groove, which is also called as the coronary groove or coronary sulcus. So, it is C-shaped and anteriorly it is not seen because of the root of the pulmonary trunk. And it is divided in the two parts. The part which is seen from the anterior aspect is called anterior part of the atrioventricular groove. And the part which is seen from posterior aspect is the posterior part of atrioventricular groove. Again, the anterior part, because of this pulmonary trunk, get divided into right anterior part and left anterior part. Right anterior part runs downwards and it contains the trunk of right coronary artery and small cardiac vein. While you get, this is the left anterior part of the atrioventricular groove, which contains two arteries, two veins. Arteries are left coronary artery with its circumflex branch and two veins, termination of great cardiac vein and commencement of the coronary sinus. So, two arteries, two veins lie here in the left anterior part of atrioventricular groove. Now, coming to the posterior atrioventricular groove. So, here you can see this is actually the diaphragmatic surface of the heart and this is the base of the heart. And this is the posterior part of atrioventricular groove, which lies between the base of the heart and diaphragmatic surface. This groove lodges the anastomosis between the right coronary artery and left coronary artery. In addition to that, it lodges the coronary sinus, which is the vein of the heart which carries 60% of the venous blood from the heart. So, that is about posterior part of the atrioventricular groove. Now, coming to the interventricular grooves. Interventricular groove actually indicates attachment of interventricular septum within the chamber of the heart. So, here this is the anterior interventricular groove, which runs downwards almost parallel to the left border of the heart, and this groove lodges anterior interventricular artery, branch of left coronary artery and great cardiac vein. Artery then winds around the inferior border of the heart to enter in the posterior interventricular groove. Coming to the posterior interventricular groove, posterior interventricular groove, you can see on the diaphragmatic surface or inferior surface of the heart, it runs forwards. It lodges the posterior interventricular artery, branch of usually the right coronary artery and middle cardiac vein. At the same time, if you divide the groove in the anterior 1/3 and the posterior 2/3, the junction between this contains anastomosis between anterior interventricular and the posterior interventricular arteries. So, that is about the posterior interventricular groove, which is seen on diaphragmatic surface. Anterior interventricular groove is seen on the sternocostal surface or anterior surface of the heart. And the two atria are separated from each other by the interatrial groove. This interatrial groove is very faint. Now, here this is a left atrium, here is a right atrium. This groove is very faint and it runs downwards and meets the posterior part of this atrioventricular groove plus posterior interventricular groove. Meeting point of this interatrial groove, posterior interventricular groove and posterior atrioventricular groove is called crux of the heart. Due to the crux of the heart, posterior atrioventricular groove get divided in the two parts. This is left posterior part which lies left to the crux of the heart and this is the right posterior part which lies to the right side of the crux of the heart. So, thus heart contains four chambers, two atria, two ventricles along with the auricles, and the grooves, atrioventricular groove which divides the atria from ventricles, interventricular groove, anterior interventricular groove present on anterior surface, posterior interventricular groove present on the inferior surface, and from the posterior view you can see very faint interatrial groove, and the crux of the heart, the meeting point of the interatrial, posterior interventricular groove and posterior atrioventricular groove. So that is about grooves and chambers of the heart.